Thank you. Hey, we just took a trip together, you know? Several hundred of us had the ability to go on a journey, and we didn't have to ingest anything other than light and sound energy. So I really hope you enjoyed the ride. For over four decades, I've been using filmmaking to take audiences on journeys through time and scale, because I love making the invisible visible. To explore the beauty and the power of nature, to unveil the mysteries of phenomena, of things that are either too slow, too fast, or too slow for the naked eye to see. And because of my moving art series, Moving Art, I received all this incredible feedback from people who told me that these programs were healing to them. Everything from children with autism, teenagers who were suicidal, patients with cancer, post-op, pre-op, and end-of-life anxiety. So I wanted to think about how I could have my work have a more direct connection to healing. The clip you just saw, that was used for a clinical trial at the Pacific Neuroscience Institute here in Santa Monica at St. John's Providence. And it was used to treat people with alcohol addiction. The name of the program is called TRIP, which stands for Treatment, Research, and Psychedelics. And in that trial, one group was given psilocybin under the supervision of a therapist, and the second group was given the same dose and watched my film on the large digital display as they were coming on. Last month, Frontiers of Psychiatry published the peer-reviewed results, which indicated that the combination was better than the psilocybin by itself, which is really groundbreaking. Patients were calmer, they were more able to ease into the psilocybin-assisted experience when they participated in this nature-themed video experience during the treatment. Also, biomarkers like blood pressure, heart rate were all lowered, and this was all indicators, I think, that nature is a healing modality. Typically, psilocybin takes about 30 to 40 minutes for it to come on. And then the patients typically talk about having a profound mystical experience. And previous studies with psilocybin show that having this incredible profound experience is often associated with long-term benefits and positive shifts in behavior and their worldview. And this is what's critical, I think, for a successful psilocybin treatment. So even though the study was about alcohol addiction, I believe that nature-assisted therapy can be really important with people with terminal cancer who are suffering from existential distress and anxiety. So it's my hope that with this imagery, we'll be able to create visual sounds and sensory inputs that can make the set and setting of the experience even more profound and tailored to the person who's being treated. Let's play the clip from Fantastic Fungi. This is a patient who was diagnosed with prostate cancer.
Was that
it made me feel more comfortable with living, you know, because you're not afraid of dying.
Frankly, I'm just a laboratory scientist, and I wasn't prepared for that.
From the memory of the transcendental state of consciousness, many people report less anxiety, less depression, less preoccupation with pain, closer interpersonal relationships, and perhaps most impressive, they claim to have a loss of the fear of death.
It recalibrates how they see death. It's been amazing hearing them talk about this idea of love. Many of them spoke about how nature itself is something like the substance called love. And having touched that, they've recalibrated it and shaped how they die differently.
So it is my hope that we can maybe create more incredible set and settings for people that are going through these, you know, sensory immersive experiences. And perhaps it can be tailored to what the person really wants. At University of California at San Francisco Neuroscape Lab, we're starting a groundbreaking study in a small room, combining my nature imagery on a 110-inch display with soundscapes, scent, and wind. And there have been studies on nature music, but nothing comes even this close to the level of integrated physiological recordings, multisensory delivery, machine learning, and analytics. I'm also using visual healing at every single room at the University of California San Diego Jacobs Medical Center, and we're also doing another clinical trial in the oncology unit. UCLA is going to begin to use my imagery for dialysis treatments, and then also my current film, Gratitude Revealed, is being used by nurses and caregivers to help them with the burnout, where they can screen the film, have a conversation to support each other. We can't forget our caregivers and nurses who are on the front lines during COVID. Thank you. So the film is free, and you go to gratitudereveal.com to sign up for a live or virtual screening. So I love turning people onto nature because beauty is nature's tool for survival because we protect what we love. It's also why I created the Louie Channel, which is a free platform with films that celebrate life. I launched it 2 months ago, and we already have 30,000 subscribers. So we have to remember that we are nature, and we are all connected.
Do you consider your films to be a visual meditation?
It is a visual meditation. I think it's actually visual healing. You don't have to think about it intellectually. You just have to, I think, let go and feel it emotionally.
Beauty, love, and gratitude are the emotions that can pull us out of the primal triggers of fear and hate. We're surrounded by that. Politics, news, even entertainment is all based on conflict and fear. The battleground today is grabbing your eyeballs, your attention, which is the same as consciousness. So we need a new story. I'm done with the macho story of survival of the fittest. How about survival of the kindest? I think we need to shift from the male-oriented point of view to the feminine point of view. Symbiosis, regeneration, nurturing, loving, care, connection. Everything is energy, life is change, and we are the changers. Thank you.
Thank you.